What's up, guys? David here, and welcome to the Fit Pro Daily. This week has been all about generating leads for your fitness business away from paid advertising and Facebook ads. And we started off the week with Lianne coming on and explaining how we can get in the media, whether that be in the news, the radio, TV, and a load of other ways. She shared her own personal experience on how she managed to get her fitness business in it, and she gave us tips and invaluable info on how you can do it yourself. Tuesday led into five different tips. Wednesday was what was working. And then yesterday was all about a foundational thing. Today, though, I want to keep it simple. I want to go over the whole week as a whole so you can have even more insight into generating leads, again, completely away from Facebook. But before I do dive into today's episode, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel just yet, press pause, press subscribe, and then let's dive into today's video. Okay, let's dive in. Now, paid advertising, we've mentioned this at the start of the week, okay, especially running Facebook ads and things like that, is going to be the quickest way to do it. But when you're running ads to a generally cold audience, there is a lot more effort that goes into it in regards to chasing these leads and then convincing them to pay. Whereas if we look at referral marketing or reactivation marketing, you're going to have a much better success rate, because if someone's referring them their friend over to you, the trust and the bond is already built. Okay, they're coming on somebody's recommendation, and recommendations are so important, such as reactivation as well. If you go and contact your previous clients that used to work with you, they know a lot more about you. You can remind them of the successes that you've had with them previously, and they should be a much easier sell when you're trying to bring them back into your fitness business. So yes, paid advertising is one way of doing it, but also non-paid or offline or online non-paid is another way of doing it, okay? And this should really be a complete ecosystem where we're not relying on one thing or just two things. We're relying on a number of different ways to generate leads for your fitness business. So if one ever does get shut down, if your ads account gets shut down or you get kicked off Facebook, you're not whole 100% relying on Facebook, and you can still be generating leads. So we've covered the five things that we talked about at the start of the week. And the week before, I gave you 18 different ways to generate leads in a five-part 10K fitness business challenge series. So literally, there are infinite ways to do it. But one of the things I would say, and like I said yesterday, is to stay consistent when it comes to generating these leads, okay? We know that if you want to do emails, stay consistent. If you want to do blogs, stay consistent. If you want to run paid advertising, stay consistent. If you want to run a free Facebook group, stay consistent. And if consistent means just doing once a week, then that is all you need to do, okay? One email a week, one blog post a week, one post into your social free group every week. Running ads, maybe just do the updates once a week. But the more consistent you stay, the more consistent your followers are going to know that you are, and the more they're going to know and trust you. But what I would really say, okay, is just have a complete ecosystem. Don't just rely on paid advertising. Don't just rely on organic marketing. Have a mixture of them both, so you have five or six different ways that people can find out into your business, and you can go from there. And what I would also say to finish this week off is to also have a marketing calendar put in place. This is where you list down everything you need to do this quarter, then break them down into separate months so you know what your focus is on. Because you might say, in June, I want to run a charity event. So that gives you a couple of months to build it up, start networking, start advertising it, start getting people involved, start building up the donations coming in. So when it comes to that charity event, it's not a big, hard push and sell to get people to come in and donate, because you've been building it up in the background. So build an ecosystem, create a marketing calendar, and you will never, ever run out of leads in your fitness business ever again. But I'm going to leave it there, as it's a bank holiday Friday, okay? I hope you've enjoyed this week. It has been a little bit different as we've really come away from paid advertising. If you have enjoyed it, comment below, let us know, subscribe to the channel, let us know that you've been enjoying it too, and I will leave it there. Enjoy the bank holiday, and I'll speak to you all soon. Cheers.